Now, our first story. For the immediate past governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, Godwin Emefiele, freedom is not yet. A federal high court sitting in Abuja has given order for the former Apex Bank boss to be remanded in the Kuje Correctional Centre, Abuja, until his bail request is perfected. You recall that the federal government accused Emefiele of fraudulently purchasing 43 automobiles for 1.2 billion naira between 2018 and 2020. He pleaded not guilty to the charge. The matter was adjourned to the 28th of November. KJ, freedom is not yet.
Well, unfortunately for the former CBN governor, he has to go back to
Islam.
Yeah, unfortunately. And for a man who has built, you can say in court, a very credible career before this period, it's very unfortunate. You know, he started as a lecturer in a Uniport, and I think in Unsuka thereabouts, you know, before going to the bank. Private sector. And even in the bank, you know, spent 18 good years, both in Nigeria and, you know, outside, before becoming the CBN governor. So it's quite unfortunate, you know, for him to end this way. But that is what you get when the CV of a man that should be the number one face of a, you know, of a monetary policy is bearing a politician, a banker, and an economist, unfortunately. A man that shouldn't have anything to do with politics, that went into the game deep, even against the CBN Act. So it's so unfortunate that he finds himself, you know, in this corner. And I've heard people say, oh, let the rule of law prevail. Of course, we expect that, you know, in all of the time, you know, for that to be the grand norm, the standard for, you know, for what we do, for what you do in a democratic setting.
Yeah.
But again, if you look at 2023, you know, what he plunged the nation into, the number of businesses, you know, that packed up, and the number of people who probably would never recover again from the shock, and you know, those political policy that is still haunting the nation till now. It's so unfortunate that you know.
Could you accept that there's an extension to that logic?
Yeah.
When you say, but he reported to the number one.
Well, the CBN. See, you have a number one who I have said in different fora. I don't always want to analyze the Buhari's government, and that's the truth. But for a number one who don't have, he did not really have the definite KPIs to measure performance of any of his appointees. You know, I remember at a time like that when he came back to the country from a trip, and he saw his the police chief, the then the IG of the Nigerian police, and he said, oh, they are complaining that you are not performing, but you are not adding weight. So for him, and you know, an office old dowry is not adding weight. You know, it simply means that he's performing. So what are the KPIs? So what are his, unfortunately, it was also
himself,
a man.
No, he himself never added weight.
No, see, if you look at his own style of leadership, I think he embraced the lesser sphere style of leadership, where you delegate absolutely, you don't even care, you know, what they do. In his own time,
you don't kick and follow.
Yes, the power, you know, lies solely with those he appointed, not even with him. You know, they weren't even sharing responsibility. It was largely on them, and you know, so much that he told his appointees that you don't have to come to me, go to the chief of staff. So many of these guys were not even reporting to him. There were middlemen in between them. And don't forget that we had a government, you know, that ran, you know, a very terrible feudalistic system, that some folks sit outside the government.
Your words.
You know, of course, please, my words. I mean, I can defend that. Some folks sit outside the government or even inside the government and they appoint people. And those ones are loyal largely to them, not even to the nation, you know, not even to Mr. President, but to those guys who appointed them into those offices. And it is what they want that they drive part time. And for a man that wanted a political position, of course, he was throwing everything, you know, to the wind just to ensure that he thought he would get the ticket of the party, you know, and be the flag bearer, unfortunately, and he was ready to do anything to end that. So for him, he was a man who is, of course, who has the experience to be a good, you know, banker at that place, you know, the banker of banker, but unfortunately, he was beclouded by the fact that he needed to play politics again, you know, for...
I think I'm beginning to understand the saying that at the top, you are alone. You stand alone.
No, see,
when,
you are
when
not...
you get there, you are alone.
Well, at this stage, at this level, I mean, or in this kind of setting, you're hardly alone. There are people with you. You know, it is what those people want. Again, you know, but now that the chips are down, of course, he's alone. But when he was taking those decisions, he was not alone. You can take it because, you know, those decisions were not for him. He was only playing to the gallery of folks.
Kalawole, we are not alone now. We are joined by the vivacious...
Delectable.
Oh, delectable is the word.
You said so.
Okay. Even about Dixon. Greetings. Welcome.
Thank you. Today's a good evening, everyone. Yeah.
You braved it, regardless.
Thank you.
Yeah. We're talking about the immediate past boss of the Apex Bank.
Okay. A very funny one. For me, I think every political appointee or anyone holding, I mean...
sensitive position.
Yes. Yeah. Be mindful of what you do. Mm. Because nemesis is waiting. When you're out of that office, it will catch up with you. Mm. Because, I mean, who would have thought that? I don't think this ever happened to any central bank governor.
Yeah.
Not in living memory.
No. Yes. Yeah. So for a man of that caliber, somebody who was the central bank governor, now being tossed up and down, EFCC is dragging him, DSS is waiting, the court is, you know, thinking about granting him bail and all of that. It's unfortunate. Mm. But then again, I would say that whatever you do is waiting for you. I mean, every good you do, it's easier for people to forget. But when you do bad, people will forever for remember what you did. We can't forget in a hurry how we suffered during the cash crunch era. It was a terrible time.
That's if the crunch is really, truly over.
At least now I can walk into the bank and demand for my money.
Okay.
You understand? But then we couldn't do that.
For me, I was becoming, I was losing touch with the use of the ATM.
And even now, that's another story entirely.
But again, that he's accused, amongst other things, of having bought about 43 automobiles for 1.2 billion naira. You know, I remember a former central bank governor who became governor of the old Cross River State. But this was after he left office. If you see what I mean.
I do. You know, when, like I said earlier, when people are in a particular office, a very high office, because they feel they are so powerful, they can do and undo, and nothing is going to happen. I know Nigeria being a country where we don't really have very strong deterrents in place. You hear people, today they are arrested, tomorrow you don't get to hear the concluding part of the story. Mm. So probably, you know, I think this case of Emefiele should serve as a huge deterrent.
All right, the next date...
Will he actually serve as a deterrent, you know? I strongly doubt it. You have a system that a lot of times, you know, play politics with even criminality. In our political system, Some things are swept under the carpet, not necessarily because they shouldn't be, you know, prosecuted or that they shouldn't be handled, but politics would always come to play, even in trials. Of course, we know that the trial is also political. It is just that you look at the fact that you weigh the option. Of course, he has also done so much more. But I doubt if they will even be very serious to prosecute him on the fact on ground. This is a fact. I know if they search deeper, there are things they will get, but I'll be connected with quite a number of people that they may not want to pull. So the one that will be a semblance of, okay, what can we hang him on? You just try to, you know, stay on that. But if they really want to prosecute him, of course, they will have much. It's not about that 1.2 billion. I think it was the fact that the man played politics. He's only suffering because he played politics, not because of those, you know, things you see. For me, you know, my judgment anyway.
Okay, we have to wait for another 10, 11 days, November 28th, to hear what's happening with him. Of course, remember the fight is about his bail.
Grandpa, just leave that.
Make her not go there.
Leave that.